Brush lag is one of the most common problems when first installing Krita and can be fixed in two ways. The first is to check your brush settings in the Tool Options Docker. If you don't see the Docker, you can try to open it by going to Settings, Dockers, and then Tool Options. If your brush is set to Weighted or Stabilizer, the brush stroke is designed to follow slightly behind your cursor in order to smooth the stroke, which would make it appear like it's lagging if you don't know that it was active. If this is the case, just click the drop-down menu and click Basic, which will smooth your stroke slightly, but it shouldn't have any lag. Now, if your brush is still lagging, it might be a problem with the type of renderer that Krita is using to render your brush strokes. To change it, you can go to Settings, Configure Krita, then click on the Display tab on the left. Here you can change your preferred renderer. At the top here, we can see we have Auto, with the renderer that Krita believes would be the best for my hardware in parentheses. Below this, we have two renderers, OpenGL and Direct3D. Direct3D is generally better for Windows operating systems, but if you're lagging and you're using Windows, switch to whatever renderer you aren't currently using. Then restart Krita and see if your brush is lagging any less. If you're still lagging, you can try clicking this button here, which will disable graphics acceleration altogether. And if you're still lagging, it's most likely the case that you don't have sufficient hardware to run Krita optimally, but we can still try a few more things. So beyond this, you can go to the Performance tab and increase the memory limit, which is the amount of RAM that Krita is allowed to use. You can check the memory available up here. I have 16 gigabytes available, so I wouldn't go above 12. You don't want to max this out because you need RAM for your computer to function. So if Krita is allowed to take up all of it, then you might crash your computer. I definitely leave at least 2 to 3 gigabytes of available memory, but if you're using less than half of your memory, then I'd push it up to 50, maybe 60%, and that should help you out. If you have 8 gigabytes of RAM, don't go above 75%, and if you have less than that, then your hardware is just lacking, and there isn't really much you can do other than use small canvas sizes with small brush sizes. One last thing you can also try is lowering the bit depth on your color space in order to take up less memory per pixel. Exit out of this window, then go to Image, and then Convert Image Color Space. This drop-down menu here contains all of the bit depths you can choose from. I currently use 8-bit, which is also the standard bit depth for most monitors, but the Krita manual recommends switching to 16-bit float to save on memory. So if you're using 16-bit integer or 32-bit, switch down to 16-bit float, and if you're already using 16-bit float, try 18-bit integer instead, and see if that helps a bit. Now, if you're in the middle of a painting, you should note that there's a good chance that this will change the colors of your artwork slightly. Here are two images that are exactly the same, but I just changed the bit depth. I'll flick them back and forth a little bit so you can see the difference. You can see that there's some clear color changes between the two. 32-bit seems a bit darker in general, but I'm sure there's some more nuanced changes that you would see in paintings with more nuanced color. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to comment down below, like the video, and subscribe if you want to see more content like this.